NCAA Division I Men's Volleyball Championship held here in beautiful Hawaii. We're at the Stan Sheriff Center getting ready for the BYU Cougars and the Long Beach State 49ers for the fourth time this year. This is the one that counts. Let's meet the starting lineups first for the Long Beach State 49ers.
Scott Tuzinski, senior, opposite St. Louis, Missouri.
Jeff Wooten, senior outside hitter, Huntington Beach, California.
Nathan Hagstrom, junior, outside hitter, Mountain Valley, California.
Duncan Bunninger, sophomore middle blocker, Encinitas, California.
David Lee, senior middle blocker, Alpine, California.
Tyler Hildebrand, sophomore center, Mesa, Arizona.
Paul Munoz, junior libero, Huntington Beach, California.
Alan Knipe is the head man in his fourth year. He's trying to become just the third coach ever to win a title as a player and as a coach. Rod Wild, Bob Yoder being the other two. And now, what about BYU? Here are the Cougars.
Joe Hillman, senior, opposite Las Vegas, Nevada.
John Alleman, senior, outside hitter, Yorba Linda, California.
Nana Pessoa, senior, outside hitter, Rio de Janeiro, Brazil.
Michael Burke, junior, middle blocker, Salt Lake City, Utah.
Victor Batista, sophomore, middle blocker, Dominican Republic.
Carlos Moreno, junior, center, São Paulo, Brazil.
Sean Olmsted, senior, libero, Carpinteria, California.
Tom Peterson is in his second year, 19th overall. He won a title with Penn State back in 94. He's trying to become the first coach ever in NCAA men's volleyball history to win titles at two separate schools. He did it at Penn State. If he wins this one, he will be unique.
And he told me right before they got ready to take the floor, he is more nervous right now than he has ever been. And I think the reason why last year he thought it was a slam dunk that he would become the first coach to take two different schools to a title. He's hoping this year it becomes destiny.
Our officials, the referee is Alan Stankitis. He's from the Midwest, working his first national championship match. There's Alan, and Ken Taylor is down. Ken Taylor, the second official. So Alan Stankitis, a lot of pressure on him. He's apt to let them go and let them play, so we don't expect to see a lot of calls as we are set and ready for first serve. BYU will serve it up first. The Cougars wearing white, and Long Beach State in the dark uniforms. We're underway. Tyler Hildebrand is the talented center for Long Beach State, number five. He's a sophomore from Mesa, Arizona. He will run the show. There's Tyler right there.
Hard to believe he's only been playing volleyball for 3 years. Did not start until his junior year in high school. That's unheard of.
Serving going to be a big key in this match. Long Beach with an outstanding serving team, as has BYU. That's set out of bounds. And Long Beach gets the first 2 points. Now, Scott Tuzinski, the man serving, one of the great servers in the country, 153 aces in his career. That is a school record, breaking the record of the great Brent Hilliard.
The amazing part about breaking that record, when Brent Hilliard played, the scoring system was different. There were a lot more opportunities to serve the ball. That just tells you how good Scott Tuzinski is.
Hilliard's record lasted for 11 years before Tuzinski broke it this year. 2-1, just the start of our first game. We'll give you the rules in a moment. Here's Carlos Moreno serving, and he pops it out of bounds. Let's go through those rules very quickly. Best 3 out of 5 games. You have to win 3 to win your match. Rally scoring. Games 1 through 4 to 30 points. All games you must win by a minimum of 2 points, and there's no cap. Long Beach's second service error.
Both teams know how critical the serving game is. Both of them playing at sea level, which is a huge difference for BYU. Both of them say the court gets bigger at sea level. You have much more area to work with, and you can hit the ball much harder.
John Alleman, a 6'3 senior from Yorba Linda, into the net. The last time these two teams played, it was May 1st, just a little bitty while ago in the MPSF championship at altitude, and BYU won 3-1. But it was closer than that. Now Lee serves. Quick set, blocked. Moreno, quick set, dug up. Hildebrand, set left. And off the block, out of bounds. Now Jeff Wooten and Nathan Hagstrom, outside hitters, could be key for Long Beach.
Well, I think so, and really they're the targets for BYU. BYU will serve the outside hitters, keep it away from the libero, and any points that they can score from the pin is a plus.
Alleman shanks it left. Here comes Pessoa, socked up in the air by Lee. Wooten. And BYU can't handle it. So Wooten gets two straight kills. Jeff Wooten is a 6'5 senior from Huntington Beach. And timeout called by BYU. So the underdog 49ers come out smoking in game one. The Beach on top, 6-2. Game one, Long Beach State leading BYU 6-2. These teams, Heather, have played three times this year. BYU winning them all, but all a little bit different.
Right, the first two that you see that both went five. The interesting part, BYU started down 0-2 in the one that they won. Long Beach started down 0-2. So both teams know how to battle back, and it seems that Scott Tuzinski is really the key to Long Beach's success.
He had a good game and lost. He had a fantastic match and lost. Then he had a crummy match and they still lost. But they were in them all right to the end. And a good start, you would think, paramount for the Beach. Fernando Pessoa, it's popped up. Long Beach in the dark uniforms. And Tuzinski hits it off the block, out of bounds, score a point.
And you know, I talked to Alan Knight before the match and I said, what is it about Tuzinski? I mean, he had a career high and then a horrible match. What makes him tick against BYU? And he said, really, the numbers are deceptive because it's about the way Tyler Hildebrand is setting him. In the last match that they lost, both Tyler and Tuzinski were pressing. Hildebrand went with what he was comfortable with and was forcing a lot to Tuzinski. Got much better in system when Tyler, the setter, is going to everybody.
Good point. Now back to serve. Maybe the most hated player in Hawaii at the moment. Victor Batista, the fans booing him already. He came to Hawaii playing with BYU, and there was some stuff that went on with the fans here. And Batista, a very cocky player. The fans booed him. We're going to see more of that.
Yeah, the reason they don't like Batista is they were playing here. Called the timeout, Batista had the ball in his hands, was ready to serve. He threw the ball at the ball girl.
Oh, that's a no-no.
People said he threw it with a little bit too much force and a little bit too high at her face. The crowd saw it, they started booing and jumped on the bandwagon and continued to boo him relentlessly throughout the match. The other thing that some don't like about Batista's game is after he serves an ace, he's got a bit of a grenade move. I mean, he does sort of this animated
pantomime of throwing a grenade over his head, which is certainly not appropriate in this day and age, especially here in the United States. 8-4 our score. Hildebrand dishing it off in the middle. Another outstanding set from Tyler Hildebrand. And putting it away, Duncan Buttinger, sophomore from Encinitas, California, down in San Diego. He dislocated his thumb against Stanford. He's been playing with that dislocated thumb the last 9 matches. You'll see that big paw tear throughout the telecast. 9-4 Beach. And the Beach coming out very strong. The bump one. We've seen it 2 times in the last couple of days. Moreno, a bad choice there. The bump one. And Burke hits it out of bounds.
And this is because of a bad pass. BYU has to have much better ball control to allow Moreno to run that fancy offense that he loves.
Right now, they're picking on John Olliman. You don't want to serve Pessoa. That's the guy they want to serve, number 12 in white. And Pessoa puts it away. Fernando Pessoa, number 17. He was a libero last year and then graduated to outside hitter this year. He's one of the best players in the country.
A truly remarkable story. You see it go the other way. You go from outside hitter to libero, but he went vice versa and now leads this team in kills and is an All-American at the outside.
10-5. Hildebrand shoots it left. Good transition play now. Olmstead with the pass. And Olliman hits it out. So Olliman, too long. John Olliman, senior from Yorba Linda, California. He was BYU's leading kill man a year ago. And he misses. 11-5. Game one, Beach on top.
Olliman deceptively good and also very strong mentally. Expect him to get out of a slump early.
Back set, nobody there. Hillman hits it out. So BYU comes in, flying the ball out of bounds. Olliman the hitting error. Hillman the hitting error, Burke had a hitting error, and Tom Peterson perplexed at the moment.
And early it was because they weren't passing well. Right now they're passing fine and still spraying him out of bounds. 0-0-0 right now, which means just as many errors as kills for Tom Peterson's club.
3 serving errors for Long Beach State as Paul Munoz checks in, the junior from Huntington Beach. He is the libero wearing white for Long Beach. Good spinner by Burke. Hildebrand, great set. And the put away.
Boy, that was
Hildebrand,
a beauty.
Going way over the net to bring that baby back.
And Hagstrom earned the start because of his passing, not because of his offense. But here, the super push by Tyler, using his legs, getting the distance. And anytime Nathan Hagstrom can come away with some kills, it's just a bonus for Long Beach.
Dzinski bombs one. BYU players crashing into each other. Free ball. Dzinski on the run. Tip. Got it. So Tuzin cruising with the twos. Big Dzinski puts it down.
Great deception. Powerful hitters are at their best when they're mixing it up. It's not always about power. It's about reading the defense. Dzinski sees that they're playing deep. Nobody's up to get the tip.
Second timeout called by the Cougars. So Allen Knipe, who won a national championship as a player in 1991, the only Long Beach State championship, he has his team out front in game one. 14-6, the Beach. Along with Heather Cox, I'm Chris Marlowe. Game one, hitting percentage seems to favor Long Beach just a bit.
I guess so. Long Beach, amazing. 8 kills early, no errors in the service game. You know, Long Beach State says our success is dictated by serving and blocking. We have to score real points, not the side out type of points that you get with your offense. Right now, Long Beach has everything they could ask for.
All-America Scott Dzinski serving again. He's not the best server in college volleyball. He's certainly the second best server. He's a 6'7 senior that was born in St. Louis, Missouri. He's got a little pet saying. He says, "That's how we get down, baby," whenever he does something good. That's how we get down, baby.
Midwestern thing?
16-6. I don't think that's a Midwest saying. It doesn't sound like it. Moreno sets left. Pretty good up into the middle. BYU has a dig. So far, it's been all Long Beach. It's BYU, either Heather, they've either come out slowly, weren't quite ready, or they're too hyped up. What do you say?
I think they're just tight. I mean, they're playing in a pressure-filled match, and I talked to a lot of the players yesterday about what happens if you get down early. When does the Lewis match start creeping into your heads? And he said, we have to erase that. We have to have a very short memory and just play this match with the confidence that we've beaten this team 3 times. But so far, I'm not seeing that confidence.
Chris Gorney is in. That's an ace. Dzinski has been superb. 3 aces for the big man.
Dzinski under a lot of pressure, not from the typical people you would think. I talked to his mom yesterday, and I said, boy, you must be proud. You know, Scott is an amazing player. And she said, well, you know, he didn't have a great match. I didn't like the way he played in game 2 in the semis. I said, Mom, come on.
The mom is tough. Another hitting error, but that's 5 hitting errors for the BYU Cougars. They also have 2 serving errors and generally lackluster play so far. 19-6, the rout is on. Dzinski is in a rhythm. Moreno quick set, Batista.
And now, that's the key. Every time there's a perfect pass, Chris, you are seeing BYU execute its offense. And Moreno telling him that, you know, that's the sign of a leader right there. They're out of timeouts, and he's bringing the team together, turning it around, asking for a little bit better ball control.
19-7, Long Beach State is up. The floater there, Hildebrand, and the put away. Another nice play by Nathan Hagstrom. Now, interestingly, Chris Gorney, who came in right before the match was to start, he came over to me and said, Marlowe, Long Beach State is going to get the silver in 3 games. He's cocky, he's confident, he's very, very good, and he's in early.
Yeah,
be interesting
in
to see if he stays in the whole way around or just as a blocking specialist.
Right, he comes in as that blocking specialist, but don't forget, he solo blocked Dzinski 5 times in 1 match. He said he was going to talk trash.
There you go.
And sure enough, he is. He said, I'm going to turn to Tyler and say, don't set the guy that I'm blocking because it's not going to give up.
Holloman's serve is out of bounds. Of course, the silver medal is the runner-up status for those of you going, what is he talking about?
Yeah, I got one of those, and it's no fun. I
the
can
beach
promise
is going
you
to get the silver. Whee! There's a good look at David
come
Lee.
Back in a hurry.
And Lee is out, and here comes Robert Kieski. Yes, it's Kieski, senior from Huntington Beach. Kieski, a pretty good player. They're using him as a server. 5 seniors on this Long Beach State squad. And that's a shank out of bounds.
Wow.
Thank you very much. They're really working on John Holloman. Holloman is having trouble. He's in the shank tank. And you don't want to serve Olmstead, the libero, or Pessoa. Much better passers. They're working on number 12.
So what Olmstead needs to do is creep to the right, take more court away from Holloman.
Holloman again. That was too high. Caught it nicely. Pessoa off the head. That's legal. And they can't quite get there.
Wow.
Good hustle by the beach. Kieski going over the top. Kieski Tuzinski. Try saying that a couple of times. And Kieski will go out. So BYU brings in big Michael Burke back into the front line. And now the boos start raining down on Victor Batista. He's got a good jump serve. Watch him elongate. Perfect pass. Hildebrand. Batista shoves it up. And Hagstrom hit the net. He hit the net. Oh!
Yeah, Moreno's a back row player, and he touched it.
Are you sure about that? Looked to me like Hagstrom hit the net.
Well, no, Moreno touched the ball, not the net, in a blocking motion, not a digging motion, which is illegal. And now, overruling, calling the net occurred first, I believe, which will give the ball back to the BYU Cougars.
I've seen a lot of plays just like that, and Hagstrom's fist hit the net. Now, what Moreno did, I wasn't quite sure, but Hagstrom will hit the net. And 22-10 with that point. And the spike is out. I want to correct something I said. I said Hagstrom hit the net. Actually, it was Jeff Wolf, Wolf number two on the left side.
And amazingly, that was just the first hitting error. This Long Beach State offense is smoking.
Borney got blocked. Borney again, waffles it. And Tuzinski tips it out. Now, if I'm the setter, if I'm Hildebrand, I don't want to set Tuzinski when he has a chance of getting stuffed. I don't want to make it obvious when you're setting Tuzinski because he's the emotional engine. If they start blocking him, then BYU can come back. They'll
right.
get
You've
that
feed on
You've
got to mix it up. Yeah. Keep Tuzinski in system. I don't think you can just dish up all the bad ball control passes where you've just got to dish it up to somebody. Go away from Tuzinski. Just give him the bread and butter sets.
Duncan Buttinger on the year hit 499. It's kind of like a batting average. The kills minus the errors divided by the attempts. Buttinger, a sensational sophomore season. Now, Jeff Wooten serving. 24-11 is our score. If you just joined us, game one, it's been all Long Beach State. Serving well behind Scott Tuzinski, hitting well. BYU has made a number of errors, both hitting and passing. Some serving.
And if I'm Carlos Moreno right now for BYU, I go back to Pessoa. He's the one bright spot on this BYU offense. Three kills, no errors, hitting 600, but nobody else has done anything for the Cougs.
And that serve is long. This is game one of our national championship final. BYU, the top-ranked team in America, the number one seeded team. Long Beach State, number two, and second-ranked. So Long Beach State going to put in the serving specialist, Thiago Barbosa from Rio de Janeiro. Kind of an undeveloped talent. Got a spinner. Good pass. Out of the back line, Borney. Dug up easily. Hildebrand. And the first block. For BYU, Michael Burke in the middle. Burke, 6'8 junior from Salt Lake City.
Great lateral movement, closes, and look at the penetration Burke gets with his forearms. Just seals that net.
So the big fella Burke goes out, and now set to serve is Rob Nielsen. He's a sophomore from Pacific Palisades High School. He's got the dig, and the slam dunk by Batista. Batista slams it. And now Nielsen will serve again. Nielsen, Palisades High School, the same school that produced Ricky Ludes, Randy Stokoe, Steve Salmons, Dave Saunders, among others. And Tuzinski flies it long.
And look, Joe Hillman remains on the bench. Don't forget, this is the guy that got BYU here. He has been the go-to player on the right side, but Joe Hillman starting out slow. One kill, two errors. Chris Gorney, the more experienced player, in as his replacement. Of course, a three-year starter.
Well, I'll tell you what, that's a tough call, Heather. Who's more experienced of those two players? Hildebrand and the putaway. Yeah, certainly, certainly Gorney has been in the championship atmosphere a little bit more, but experienced Hillman, he's been around the block, hasn't he?
Thanks to Big Joe. No doubt who that is.
Yeah, Mr. Hilden.
I love it. I was reading Joe's bio. He wrote, hometown, Las Vegas. Most notable thing about hometown, it's Las Vegas. What stays in Vegas, what happens in Vegas, stays in Vegas.
There you go.
No secrets to be told there by the Hillman family.
Here's Scott Tuzinski, three aces. Took a little something off that. Moreno sets left. Oh, that's no good. Oh, and there it goes. A la Pat Powers, the former USC Olympian.
That's way not back even when. A wall ball.
He reached the cheap seats on that one here at the Stan Sheriff Center. Woo! And how about LBSU's points when Tuzinski at the line scored eight. Tuzinski, Olmstead shanks, free ball. Long Beach trying to slam it was Hildebrand, and he did. Hildebrand does not spike very often. He will not use that. The most kills he's had in a match this year, four. But that time, very effective.
I love it, the deception. He's got two hands up at the last minute, snaps with that left hand. That's right, so helpful to be a lefty in the setter position.
Well, Moreno, wow, he's a little bit bewildered about what's going on right now. Horrible passing, which can make any setter look awful. Ball is up, Lee's got it. Munoz. And over the top and down. Nathan Hagstrom, he's getting the start because he's a good passer. Great ball control digger over Robert Tarr.
But a great start. Four kills already for Hagstrom, the junior. Back and forth, as you said, with Tarr. And any offense he can provide, he's doing more than ask.
Heather, the first of 14 game points for Long Beach.
Ouch.
Scott Tuzinski, arguably the best server in the nation.
BYU out of timeouts, trying to slow things down by wiping up the floor, tying their shoelaces, trying to get in Tuzinski's head.
Yeah, they're going to have to get out the Johnson & Johnson wax if they want to slow this one down. Tuzinski for the win. Got it! Scott Tuzinski, that's how we get down, baby. And the Beach has won game one, 30-15. Wow. Four aces for Tuzinski. And Long Beach off to a one game to none start. We'll be back. Who would come out revved up in game one? Would it be the loosey-goosey 49ers or the serious and studious BYU Cougars? It was Long Beach. On the outside, Nathan Hagstrom was outstanding. Tuzinski, three aces. Make that three kills and four aces. And Long Beach on a 19-6 run. They win going away 30-15. Back with Heather Cox. I'm Chris Marlowe. What stood out in that first game, Heather?
Well, just the efficiency of Long Beach State. You look at the 435 hitting percentage combined with Tuzinski making an impact on every area of the floor. Those five service errors, aces, four by Scott, just critical for the Beach. And you can tell they came in relaxed. They came in confident. You know, I think it's interesting. If you polled all the coaches in the country, 99% of them would say, I'd much rather face somebody for the first time than the fourth time. Long Beach State seems to have BYU's number, especially Scott Tuzinski.
Now the question is, did Long Beach State win that first game too easily? Can they keep their momentum?
No such thing.
And what about BYU? Can they rebound? They put Hillman back in, so it's the initial starting lineup for the Cougars. They have flopped their lineup, however.
I like that substitution. Get Hillman back in, give him a rest, give him a chance to sort of get composure of his nerves. This is the first time he's ever played in a match of this caliber. The other key for BYU, they have got to rotate out of Tuzinski's rotation. No surprise that Coach Knipe starts with Tuzinski serving.
Yeah, and Burke is in the left front now, so they've rotated around three spots. And Michael Burke hits the first one straight down. So Burke starting in the front line, Batista in the back line. We're at the Stan Sheriff Center. We're live in Honolulu, the NCAA Men's Division I Volleyball Championship. Pretty good crowd on hand watching the top-ranked BYU Cougars and the second-ranked Long Beach State 49ers. The two best teams in the country, no doubt about that. Long Beach State in game one was all over BYU. Got a huge lead at 22-8 and one going away. John Alleman, one of the solid building blocks for BYU, had an awful first game. Alleman hit zero.
Long Beach State just attacked him. Look for them to serve the middle of the court right now. Force him to pass the ball.
1-1. And a shaky pass. Lee out of the back line. Tuzinski. Spinner! Pancake!
That's up.
Olmstead apparently got that up. Free ball, Hildebrand. Lee, nice up by Hillman. BYU just not smooth. Pessoa takes a rip.
The problem is, every time Carlos Moreno is setting the ball, he's out of position because none of the balls are coming up to the net. Look at the defense by Olmstead. First big play Sean Olmstead's made in this match, and finally transition, able to score points for the Cougs.
Olmstead, a 6'2 senior out of Carpinteria, California. Dad, Rick, a tremendous beach player, played at the at BYU Hawaii, interestingly, his college ball.
That was Rick Olmstead, one of the nicest guys in the world. Now just a world-renowned official on the beach circuit.
Olmstead's got it up. Gorney, and the put-away is by Hillman.
That's what BYU needs. They need one player to gain the fire, gain the confidence, and gain some consistency. Just keep BYU plugging away with transition.
BYU 28-4 overall. Their losses to Pepperdine twice, Cal State Northridge, and at UCLA near the end of the season. Good serve. Hildebrand sets left. And BYU gets the stuff. Moreno was there with Burke. 4-1. Not sure who got it, but if you're little, you got to take credit
Moreno.
For it.
Moreno, watch number five. Blocking line gets all the way out to the antenna, drops his right hand in. Perfect execution.
4-1. Pessoa. Dzinski. Nice up. Pessoa calling for it. Instead, over to Alleman. And I think that Moreno is trying to get Alleman going, and so far he hasn't been able to. He had the back set open there, but chose to go to Alleman.
And you can see Moreno really thinking. I mean, you can almost see the churning and the smoke coming out of his ears, really trying to figure out how he can get his team best, you know, to play its best.
Now, if you're Alleman, you got to go to Moreno and say, hey, listen, I know I'm off to a crummy start, but set me again.
Yeah, I'm
set
good.
It out here. I'll get it.
Yeah, help me get back into rhythm here.
BYU with its worst single game loss since rally scoring was invented. 2003, they lost to Pepperdine 30-18. Their first game loss 30-15. Batista with the drive.
I like Moreno going into the middle. The key to that, you've got to have good passing, but right now he does. So go to Batista and go to Burke. And look at the energy you're getting out of Batista. Emotion, confidence, that's what this team needs.
Michael Burke will serve, hitting 531 on the year, and a quick timeout taken by Long Beach State. Beach won game one, but it's a different story so far here in game two. Chris Marlowe, Heather Cox. BYU looks like a different team so far here in game two. Pessoa gets the dig. BYU leading 6-2 and now 7-2 as John Alleman finally gets his first kill.
And give credit to Carlos Moreno, having the confidence, knowing that in order to win this match, they need John Alleman involved.
Michael Burke, again, set to serve. It's a bouncer off the net. Hildebrand shoots it left, and the put away. Jeff Wooten gets the kill. The 2002 Dodge Parker Award winner, the Iron Man, named for the former great setter at Long Beach State who passed away some years ago, Dodge Parker. Generally regarded as one of the greatest setters in United States history, and a man who Tyler Hildebrand will be compared to throughout his career. Hildebrand sets middle, Pessoa's got it. Left side, Alleman, and Alleman 2-for-2.
What a difference a game makes. You said BYU looks like a different team. I think the reason why, you can credit Coach Tom Peterson for flip-flopping the rotation. What that did is it got Michael Burke, one of the best blockers, on Jeff Wooten. It also got Batista on Tuzinski, and it opens things up on the outside for Alleman.
Sometimes just looking at a different face after you get ripped is a good idea. Moreno with a big serve. Tuzinski over the top. Pessoa there again. Back set. Hillman. Flopper. Joust coming. No. Alleman. Three in a row for John Alleman. So after a slow start, Alleman.
And he's loving the matchup he has. Big seam in the block thanks to the overpass, and shows how mature Alleman is, having the ability to mentally refocus after just a dismal game one.
So first game all Beach, second game all Cougs so far. 9-3 our score. Carlos Moreno, it is reported that he slept in his crib with a volleyball. His dad, a four-time Olympian for Brazil. I think that's true, Heather?
I do. In fact, he said, I was born with volleyball, literally and figuratively. First gift he ever received as a baby was that volleyball.
Duncan Buttinger pounds it through.
Budinger coming off of a huge semifinal match. 11 kills, but the most important part, his hitting percentage, 667 to lead the Beach past Penn State.
9-4, Cougars. Nice pass, Olmstead. Sean Olmstead in the semifinal had 21 receptions and no reception errors, which is the kind of percentage you're looking for.
Which leads you to wonder, why on earth would you serve the libero 21 times? Sean Olmstead just nails when it comes to passing and doing much better in game two than he did in game one.
There's a perfect pass, and Budinger again. So Long Beach trying to get going here and set the middle. They have two outstanding middle hitters in Duncan Budinger and David Lee. There's Budinger. Of course, his brother, the younger brother, Chase, is an outstanding young volleyball player, one of the best in the country down in San Diego, being looked at as a youngster. I believe he's just 15 years old.
Not just a great volleyball player, but also a great basketball player.
Pessoa now with 5 kills. Pessoa, a senior from Rio de Janeiro, a 3-year starter at Libero. And now Victor Batista. In practice the other day, they actually had the BYU fans boo him to get him used for it.
I was
used
here. To it, did you? It wasn't even just the fans. Yeah. It was the host. It was everybody in the gym, which was just firing Batista up.
11-5, Pessoa. And apparently that's outside the antenna. I think if you're going to block one guy in your Long Beach, you stop Pessoa because he's the fiery guy, the talkative guy, the ignition switch.
Right, and he's the one that said a year ago as a libero, I had to be much more even-keeled, steady Eddie. I couldn't let my emotions shine. This year, I can be that real emotional, fiery guy, and BYU needs that right now.
Big serve, handled well. Pessoa. And it's off a hand out of bounds. So Fernando Pessoa.
And interesting, he just went up to Carlos and told him he needed the set to go a little bit farther outside. Carlos Moreno's sets are dropping inside right now, which to me is a sign of nerves. You're not using your legs enough to push it out to that hitting window right by the antenna.
Nothing worse than getting a low inside set, a trap set they call it. Now here's Joel Hillman.
Recipe for disaster.
Set left. Moreno, shoot it. And Pessoa again. So for Fernando, Pessoa has been very, very reliable now with 7 kills.
And this set goes all the way to the outside. The jump set, it's a great push. And believe it or not, Pessoa looks right at Moreno, winks at him, and gives him the thumbs up sign, like much better. Moreno's the competitive type of guy, too. If he hears from Fernando that he didn't get a great set, he's going right back at him with the perfect set.
13-6, BYU on top here in game two. David Lee, they really haven't gotten David Lee involved yet. That set a little bit off the mark. Lee just with 2 kills. Timeout, 14-6, and a timeout taken. We're coming back. We're in the midst of the national championship final. Long Beach State looking good in game one, but here in game two, it's the Cougs. Long Beach leads it 1-0. Of course, the BYU program is a relatively young program, began back in 1990. Carl McGowan was the man who put together the architect, and now taking over is Tom Peterson. You see 2 national championships, and of course, this BYU team has really been one of the powerhouses in men's volleyball since.
They have truly become one of the great programs in the country, and I love it. We talked to Val Hale, the athletic director, right before the match, and we were talking about men's volleyball, and he said, I love it. You know, I love Tom Peterson. I love this program because it's high dividends, low maintenance.
Yeah.
It's every athletic director's dream. Bring you a couple titles, have a great coach, no scandals, no trouble.
Tom Peterson, Grayson DeBose, Sean Patchell, the coaching staff for the BYU Cougars. I'm sure Carl McGowan, wherever he is, he's now a USA assistant coach with Doug Beal going to the Olympics. Wherever he is, he's watching intently his former BYU Cougars. And we certainly want to send out our best wishes to Susan McGowan, his wife, who's been battling some health problems. We hope that she gets better. What a wonderful woman. The McGowan's certainly synonymous with BYU volleyball.
They got BYU on the map, and he is an incredible addition to Doug Beal's men's national team staff.
15-8 our score at BYU, leading by 7. If you just joined us, Long Beach bombed BYU in game one, 30-15. Now Clint Coe has come into the match, 6'3", senior from Quartz Hill, California. We saw him as a blocking specialist for Hildebrand in the semifinal. And the serve is missed. So the happy smiles we saw on Long Beach earlier, not there at the moment as they try to hang in. And now here is Michael Burke.
Basically, what Long Beach did in game one is took advantage of a very subpar execution game from BYU. Now we're seeing the BYU everybody's seen all season long.
Off the net, nice up by Hillman. Set left one-on-one and punching it through was Jeff Wooten. So Wooten gets the kill. Long Beach State hitting 350 this year. That's their team hitting average. So you got to give a lot of credit to their setter.
Well, and their outsides in this match have been superb. 9 kills combined now for Wooten and Hagstrom.
16-9, and Batista hits it out.
Wow, and really not a blocker up. Both blockers on their way down. Batista had a wide open court. Look at this, boom, and hits it out. He's got to keep that ball in play.
Now the question is, would Moreno set him again? Set him again, Moreno. Let's see what you got.
Good pass.
Here he comes. Nope, missed it. And Long Beach guesses right.
Yeah,
they
Moreno,
don't jump with him.
Moreno needs to read that. He's got to read that the two blockers have committed to the outside, and there's a one-on-one in the middle.
The first block of the match for Long Beach. And slamming it through was Carlos Moreno. Of course, the Brazilians have always had a very prideful volleyball heritage. The men's team won the gold medal in 1992. I believe Moreno's dad was not on that team. He was on some of the earlier teams for Brazil. Into the middle to Zinski. They dig him. Free ball. Back set. Buttinger with the drive. So Duncan Buttinger gets the kill. And Long Beach trying to creep back.
And blocking just hasn't been much of a factor in this match so far. What is Alleman doing? He's got to communicate. When the hitter goes behind the setter, that becomes Alleman, the left front player's responsibility.
Set to serve it is Jeff Wooten. Game two, BYU leading by 5. Moreno over the top and down goes Hillman. If you didn't know it and you looked at Joe Hillman, you'd say he's 22 years old when you look at his face. He's 27. He's 27, soon to be 28. One of the veteran members, and of course, big Joe Hillman. We're not going to speculate on his age. Big Joe.
Yeah, if you're wondering why Joe is so old and still eligible, 4 years at Utah Valley, didn't count against his eligibility, wasn't a full-time student. Yeah.
And before that, he had gone on a religious mission. That ball hits the scoreboard, and it's in play. Hits the scoreboard, you stay in play, and Long Beach stopped. If it hits the scoreboard, I believe, and stays on your side,
you can still play.
It's in play.
And it's almost like neither team knew. BYU was starting to celebrate. Long Beach was walking away. They've got to stay in this mentally, both teams.
Holloman with the serve. Long Beach been passing just okay. Hagstrom is blocked. So Hillman, little Joe was there.
And Batista as well. Both of them did a nice job read blocking. Tyler Hildebrand, very hard to read, very deceptive hands.
20-12 now. So the Mountain Pacific Sports Federation champs, the MPSF champs, turning it on now. Olivet gets his first ace. And the first ace for BYU.
Which is so surprising considering just how important serving is in this match. Both teams have such potent offensive attacks that the serve is the best line of defense. If you serve tough, you pull the pass off the net, you pull the setter off the net, they can't run all their offensive options.
Hagstrom has gone out. Now Robert Tarr, a 6'6" sophomore, is in. Tarr, the better hitter blocker. Wow, this is his first attempt. Look at that, baby. Tarr's a good player. Doesn't pass or dig quite as well. Pessoa munches one. Fernando Pessoa. And he's telling Moreno, that's perfect. That's just goosey.
Just like I like it. 8 kills now for Pessoa, who leads all attackers. Long Beach showing more balance. All 5 attackers very involved.
Yeah, but they're having trouble putting the ball away. There's a kill for Buttinger. Who's off to a great start to his Long Beach State career. Now Lee back in.
Yeah, Buttinger continuing to light it up. 6 kills, no errors, 667. The exact same hitting percentage he had in the semis against Penn State. That's efficiency.
67, 2 out of every 3. That'll get the job done. So right now, Long Beach with the serve, trailing big. Kieski. And Pessoa is hot, and Moreno knows it.
Feed the hot hand.
They run that low set, and it's very, very effective. Hard for the blockers to get there, Heather.
And what I like, I mean, you see the two quick attacks leaving Pessoa open on the outside. Pessoa went straight to Sean Olmstead, the libero that passed the ball, to say thank you. I mean, it really starts with that first contact.
Batista. And the smackdown for David Lee. So Lee gets a kill. Lee is 6'8". Buttinger is 6'8". Aren't many little fellas left in the world of men's volleyball. Even John Olliman, who looks kind of short on the BYU side, he's 6'3". Kaczynski has not been quite as effective here in game two. And Burke get the kill. And the official explaining he has to touch it for the fourth time before I can make the four-touch call. Robert, make that Allen Stankitis making the call. A 10-point advantage for BYU. Hillman serving. Out of the middle, nobody there. And, love that play. Set it up with a 31, and all of a sudden hit someone hitting a low pipe.
And I love using the pipe as an offensive option, not just as an outlet. Tyler Hildebrand really doing an incredible job setting with diversity, getting all the attackers in.
24-15. And Burke. We mentioned in the semifinal, if you didn't hear the story, out at the start of the year, he tore a pectoral muscle bench pressing. I found out the true story. He had bench pressed 327 pounds the week before, and he wanted to try 365. He said, in my mind, someone was telling me that's a stupid thing to do, and he tore his pectoral muscle, and he was out for about a month.
Yeah, it was pretty funny yesterday hearing him tell the story. He just looked and said, you know, I knew something bad was going to happen. I don't know why I
yep,
did it.
Yeah, absolutely.
Sure enough, he missed about 12 matches during the season. In fact, didn't play against Long Beach State in two of the matches this season.
Burke, first 12 matches of the year. And he has put together a tremendous physique. And he snaps another one down. So that torn pectoral, Heather, you can breathe easy because the torn pectoral is okay.
Yeah, he told me yesterday the only time it hurts is really when he whiffs the ball. When he mishits it, he gets a little bit of a sting and a pain in there. But otherwise, it's good to go.
Rob Nielsen in again.
I'm mad at Mike Burke, though.
How come?
Filled out his questionnaire.
Yeah.
Listen to
he
what
gave
his
you
hobbies.
A lot of fake.
Oh, yeah.
Fake.
Really into beekeeping, fencing, likes to do model airplanes in his spare time. I'm thinking this is one of the most unusual players you'll see, sure enough.
Heather, you're so gullible. Heather actually called the Beekeeper Society and asked for Mike Burke. Anybody who knew Mike Burke at the Beekeeper Society on the Big Island. 26-17, BYU in command here. And what has been the difference in this game in terms of BYU? How have they gotten
ball
it together?
Ball control, and they're keeping their serve in. They're passing, allowing Moreno to run the offense, and they're serving better. I mean, they had, I think, 5 service errors in game one. They just came flat out tight. Also, Jonathan Olliman, who needs to be a consistent force, had a horrible game one, has been superb in game two.
Chris Gorney is in, and he's going over to try to block Kaczynski. Not that time.
Gorney told me when he goes in as a blocking specialist, the first thing that goes through his mind, one, don't miss the serve so he can have a chance at blocking. The second thing that goes through his mind is, I'm going to chat it up with Hildebrand and tell him, don't set the guy I'm blocking against.
First kill of this game for Scott Tuzinski. Not enough. And the Long Beach 49ers trailing big.
Which is interesting because in the semifinals against Lewis, came out, had a great game one, 8 kills, no errors. In game two, he was very subpar. Just ask his mom.
First game point for BYU, John Olliman serving. This could be it. This should be it. Now it's back row attacker.
Sweet.
And BYU has won game two. They're saying back row attacker. I guess it doesn't make any difference. Hildebrand, I believe, was in the back court. Try to disguise that. So Carlos Moreno gets the Cougs underway in game two. Batista was a factor. And BYU wins it 30-18. We'll continue more in a minute. After getting crushed in game one, BYU got mad. The Cougars came alive with John Alleman hitting on the left side. Long Beach not up to it in game two. Batista tearing it up. Alan Knipe trying to shift his lineup around a little bit. Tyczynski, only one kill in the game. And the Cougars were all over the 49ers. Gordy chipped in. And at the end, it was BYU big, 30-18. We're back at the Stan Sheriff Center. Along with Heather Cox, I'm Chris Marlowe. Statistically, well, hey, we're almost even, Heather.
Wait, exactly, and I think the service story tells the tale for the first two games. Long Beach in game one had a bunch of aces, had five. In game two had zero aces and four errors. So really the service story is telling the tale of this match so far. Hitting percentage also just drastically different for both teams between game one and two. Look at the improvement for the BYU Cougars. .043 jumped up all the way to above 500. And remember, it's a lot like a baseball percentage batting-wise. And you know that 500 is pretty darn good.
So BYU with a big game two as we set for the start of game three. The winner of this game historically has had a big leg up in a split type format. So Hillman, Pessoa, and Burke in the front line. Starting to serve will be Victor Batista. Tyczynski, and they've got to get him going. Was that ball good? No. That ball hit the ground. Alan Stankitis makes the call. The Lewis Flyers are here. The Flyers, after getting beat in the semifinal, had a chance to talk to them. They're not rooting for BYU. No love lost, and the Lewis Flyers and the BYU Cougars, they're going for the beach tonight.
I talked to Jared Drayton, though, the freshman.
Yeah.
You know, looking ahead, I said, well, what's next for you? He goes, well, on Saturday, I'm going to Kappa Valley's high school prom. You know, oh, spoken like a true freshman. The guy in the gray shirt right in the middle there, you know, too young and dumb to know any better, not as disappointed as, you know, perhaps he would be if he were a senior and heading to my old alma mater, Capistrano Valley High School, for a little prom action.
Lewis had a terrific year, considering the circumstances, considering they lost two first-team All-Americans, a great setter. It was an outstanding year for Dave Dozier.
Yeah, literally the Cinderella story of this year.
Lee gets the kill, just the start of game three. Is this a must-win game for either of these teams?
I don't think so. They're experienced, they're wily. You know, if there was a very young team here, I'd say yes, but these two teams have battled. They know each other so well. I'm counting on five games in this one.
Moreno with a bump. I think one of the big keys will be the Long Beach State serving. Can they get their serves in? Can they make them hard? Olmstead, one-hander, and Hillman goes and gets it. Pessoa, no. So a tremendous up by Olmstead, and Hillman, as long as it gets, going to retrieve it. Watch the hustle.
Incredible. I mean, look at the guy in blue, the libero, keeping things alive. Transition volleyball, crucial for scoring points.
Pessoa gets it. Pessoa, a dead cross-court hitter. You got to block his seam. You have to take away his angle. If you can do that, and David Lee shaking his head, thinking, ah.
Well, the trouble is, it's so hard for David Lee to read Moreno. He told me yesterday, Carlos Moreno is by far, there's not even a close second, the toughest setter to read. Just his hands are so deceptive that oftentimes he'll leave a seam because he's late to the block.
Pessoa having a great match, with the exception of that serve. So the miss there, 4-2 Long Beach, just the start of game three. And now set to serve is David Lee. So Lee got a little jump floater from the left side. That's a terrible serve. Missed it.
And the jump floats were just huge for Long Beach State in their win over Penn State. In fact, Alan Knipe said it wasn't the jump serve or top spins that scored points for us. It was those floaters. So much movement. It's really hard to get behind the ball.
Burke with the spinner. And tapping it off the block is Wooten. So Jeff Wooten with his sixth kill. And there is Dave Dozier, the head coach for the Lewis Flyers, the defending national champions.
One of the all-time nicest men in the game, too.
And a pretty darn good volleyball coach. Hillman, nice up by Hildebrand. And the put away. So Jeff Wooten.
Boy, I like the balance we're seeing from the 49ers. Wooten, eight kills. David Lee, seven. Buttinger, six. And it's amazing, Tyczynski has five, but he's the lowest out of all the main hitters.
Hildebrand with a little jump floating. But Batista coming around the top. Batista, a sophomore from the Dominican Republic. He joined the team in January. That really solidified their lineup.
Well, and it's remarkable that he's become such a huge factor. He was really the missing ingredient, the one missing piece to the puzzle. And the fact that he didn't arrive in Provo until January, I mean, they're already in the thick of their season, has made a big impact.
6-4 our score. Nice up by Buttinger. Big play here. Tuzinski got it.
BYU has got to put that away. They can't let Long Beach State score a point on a mistake. I mean, virtually a mistake on the overpass. Alleman needed to put that ball away.
Beautiful play right here by Wooten. No.
And nice heads up play. Buttinger getting it up.
Keep that play alive.
That's a gimme.
Get a kill. 7-4. Moreno back. Alleman chopping.
Nice set.
John Alleman, he was an all-tournament selection a year ago despite losing. Remember BYU, they lost three players from a year ago. Jaime Mayol, Luca Slabe, and Rafael Paul. Three very good players. With plenty of guys to come in and back them up. Hildebrand, bad set. The first real bad set for Tyler Hildebrand, the setting wunderkind.
And he was just trying to do too much. He was right there. Setting the outside would have been the easy choice. He went for the high risk, high reward.
You know, getting back to that set by Hildebrand, Harlan Cohen, the former national team coach and coach of Pepperdine, he always used to say, a good set is first, a smart set, then a tricky set. That time the order was reversed for Hildebrand.
Very good advice, especially for a young setter.
Harlan Cohen, one of the great setting coaches of all time. Tuzinski. Olmstead, beautiful dig, and teeing off. That's out of bounds. So BYU digging in, and Long Beach State hitting it out. 8-7 now.
Moreno giving the love to Olmstead. Well deserved.
Now, Victor Batista ready to serve. Serve it into the net so they can really razz it. And off Alleman, OB. So another kill for Long Beach State. And now Scott Tuzinski, who served 10 points from his serving rotation. He had three aces, making 11 points in game one, zero in game two. Mike Sondheimer, our stat man, give us that information. Moreno paddles it left. Nice up, here they come. Hildebrand up and over and out. And over and out, up and in. Tyler Hildebrand with some athletic ability. Boy, talked about some of the great setters in Long Beach history. Dodge Parker, Tom Ashen, Jason Stimfig, who led the team to a national title, Chris Seifert, and of course now Tyler Hildebrand.
Seifert on the U.S. roster.
He is. And Burke is there. No, Hildebrand and Lee just not connecting hard that time, Heather.
Yeah, not at all like we saw them in the semifinals.
9-9.
Mike Burke certainly has a lot to do with that. Very intimidating, imposing force at the net.
And now set to serve, Little Joe. No, not Cartwright, Hillman. Out of the back line, and
gets the hill. That's a sweet offensive play. Tyler Hildebrand calling the play. What he did is he overloaded one blocking zone. He ran a quick play into the middle, got the blockers in the air, and then set the back row pipe. I love it.
Nathan Hagstrom serving. And Hillman hit it out. So Hillman hits it out, Long Beach forges a two-point lead, and Alan Knipe, his coaching staff, Greg Vernovich, and Andy Reid. Great job that squad has done this year. Coaching staff and veterans. And the serve out. I've got a prediction for you, Heather.
All right, throw it to me.
It's in the early moments of game three. If Long Beach State doesn't get Tuzinski more active, they've got to set him more balls, he's got to get more kills. If Tuzinski doesn't come on, Long Beach is going down in this match.
I'll flip that for you. If Hillman doesn't come on for BYU, they lose this match as well. Hillman just three kills, three errors. Both teams need their opposite players to become active.
Tuzinski with six kills and three errors, not getting the ball enough at the moment. The touch called. There he is, Scott Tyszynski, one of the great hitters and servers in America. National team candidate in 2008. And now Pessoa will serve.
We talked to Doug Beal, the U.S. Olympic men's coach, who's here, about some of his favorites. Yeah. He's really high on Tyler Hildebrand. He's just a sophomore. But Doug Beal, the gentleman in the glasses in the middle, said that Tyler Hildebrand, he could easily see setting the 2018 because of his competitive fire. He said he's an athlete playing the setter position.
Hildebrand slams. Good up by Moreno. Alleman tip. Buttinger gets the kill. The Long Beach State digging it up, putting it away. Duncan Buttinger.
And Buttinger's still perfect. 6 kills on the night, 0 errors.
13-11 Long Beach, game 3. Hildebrand, sneak it to Buttinger. 7-for-7. Heather Cox like numbers.
Oh, in my dreams, in my dreams, Marlo.
Okay, in your dreams. Once again, Buttinger playing with that big paw pad on his left hand. He's got the dislocated finger. And now his buddy, David Lee, to serve. Beach up by 3, game 3. National championship, glad you're with us. Live volleyball on ESPN2. Chris Marlowe, Heather Cox, going all the way in this one. You can feel it. And slamming it down, Moreno got the net.
Huge break for Long Beach State. Nobody up. Moreno with a wide open court. Boy, watch the way Moreno reacts to that. That could be a huge turning point in this match.
Timeout Cougars. Allen Knipes 49ers turning it on a bit now. They lead by 4. First time since 1998, a band is playing here at the Stan Sheriff Center. Explain.
This is just truly bizarre to me, Chris. This is the first time Mike Wilton right there, the head coach for the men's Hawaii volleyball team, doesn't like having a band in the gym. He has forbidden the Hawaii band to play, so this is the first time since 98. At that point, it was for the national championship as well. Again, Hawaii wasn't even playing, so never when Mike Wilton is coaching is there a band in the house.
Well, that's the Long Beach State Band, in case you're wondering. And I think one of the reasons is, I think Hawaii has a number of guys that beat the drums,
right,
and they do the congas, and they've got all this stuff going, and the band, I think, just gets in the way here in Hawaii. Michael Burton.
I think you want any home court advantage you could get.
Bench pressing 360. What I don't understand in that whole story about the bench press, he did 327. Why would you go to 365?
Jump up to 365.
Yeah, go to 320.
Put fives on each side. Come
or
on, go
two,
by 10.
Two and a halfs is what I do.
You have nothing to prove, Mike. You beekeeper, you.
Little slapper through the block, Jeff Wooten. If you just joined us, Long Beach State got off to a great start in game 1 and won handily, 30-15. Game 2 was all BYU. They came back and pounded Long Beach. This is the start, well, the first half of game 3. And really, you have to figure the team that wins this game is going to have a huge leg up.
And serving continues to be critical. Long Beach State serving so well that they're pulling Carlos Moreno off the net. That makes it so much easier to read him and get a better block up. Serving and blocking, the key to Long Beach's success.
3-point Beach lead. Ooh, that could have been out. Hildebrand sets left. And Tuzinski with a little off-speed stuff. Now he's got 7 kills. Now remember, in one of the earlier meetings this year, he had a career-high 40 kills.
Insane.
So he's going to need somewhere, I believe, in the 20s.
Yeah, he also
for Long
is coming
Beach to win this match.
Just 7 days ago, had 14 kills, hit 049 against this very same team.
I think he asked you not to mention that, didn't he, Heather?
His mom did.
Forget about that. Serve into the net. So BYU will have it back. The Cougars are runner-up a year ago. And they trail it by 3. John Alleman. Tyszynski got it. So Scott Tyszynski, kill number 8. Now David Lee will come back into the front line. Big number 21. Lee, the big blocker. Tyszynski gets the kill. There's Lee. He says he watches the hands of Moreno. Getting back to your point, he watches the hands because that's where the release comes, and he's always trying to guess and try to figure out where Moreno is going.
Yeah, he said watching on tape as Moreno makes the calls. He's calling those plays before every single serve receive.
Bad pass. Oh, could have been double contact there. No call. Set high left, Pessoa. They got him! It all started with a bad pass. Remember in game one, Heather, they served Alleman and he didn't pass very well. That started with a bad pass.
Yeah, it's like a domino effect. If you don't get a bad pass, you become so predictable and really lets it makes your offense suffer.
So Long Beach State gets a stuff block. They're second, and they lead by five. Back inside the Stan Sheriff Center, we're tied at one game apiece. Here in game three, it was tied 9-9, but Long Beach State fashioning some good serving. They're getting production now from Tuzinski. Hagstrom looks good on the left. And Robert Kieski serves. Hillman off the top. And Hagstrom can't find it. So BYU gets a point. Remember, it's rally scoring or point per play scoring. Here's a good look at Scott Tuzinski.
A little hot and cold. Game three, by far his best game in this match so far.
Yeah, it's no doubt that BYU is keying on him, so they've got the blockers waiting and ready, but I still think you got to set him.
Yeah, the reason he's had so much more success in this third game is Hildebrand is using him in system.
And BYU thought it had the block. And it looked like Tuzinski hit it off the block, but it landed on the line. Or apparently hit Tuzinski, one of the two. It may have brushed Tuzinski going out.
Those balls are coming so fast off the block. Sometimes as a hitter, it's hard to get away from it. Tagged him on the way out.
19-16. Oh, that's frustrating. Once again, Victor Batista. This guy never misses. BYU, and that is a brain cramp. I think Pessoa gets credit for it. They had a plum on the net, and they couldn't figure out what they were going to do with it.
And Chris, that's 2 points they've given away like that. I mean, simple gimmies. This is uncharacteristic out of BYU.
Yeah, the guy who's on hand, right hand, should take that.
Especially when they could have gotten Tuzinski out of his serving rotation.
Free ball. Hildebrand into the middle. And it's going to be Long Beach ball.
Wow, they're calling Burke over. BYU just breaking down right now.
Explain the rule, Heather, real quick.
The ball has to cross the plane of the net before you can attack it. You have to give the setter the opportunity to set the ball. They are saying that Burke reached over.
First referee, Alan Stankaitis, saying the ball was settable. If there's any part on the BYU side, they can go get it. But I don't think that time, like Burke got it a little bit early. 21-16, Long Beach.
And again, Tuzinski rolling, scoring points with a serve.
Whoa! Pessoa up 30 feet. And David Lee, I think he's figured it out, Heather. He said, I'm going to stay inside on Pessoa and block cross court.
Drop that hand and take away the seam. And what makes Long Beach so good in this rotation, it's not just Tuzinski serving, but it's that David Lee is patrolling the net as well. A great combo.
Part of the time.
Yeah, and he ran that play much better in the semifinals against Lewis. We haven't seen Joe Hillman become a huge factor so far. They need to run him in system, out of the back row a little bit more. That's what you do as a right side player. You hit that back row attack.
Another big serve by Tuzinski. And another block at the net by Davey Lee.
Boy, Alan Knight told me that the key to this fourth meeting is that we must play at a higher level longer. We must play harder longer. We had moments of brilliance the first three times, but in this fourth game, we must maintain. And it's exactly what they're doing with their serve and block.
Tuzinski finally hits one out. Would you say there's a good side and bad side in here, Heather? All the games, the two games that have been won here on the left side of the court, and game three looks like it's going to go to the left side of the court. Could there be any advantage?
I think that's coincidence.
Okay, there you go.
Yeah, outdoors, definitely a good side, bad side in here. I don't think there's a difference.
Hillman with the serve. 23-17 our score. Spiking it through hard was Nathan Hagstrom, junior from Fountain Valley, California. He's not relied on so much to hit, but he's doing a pretty good job in this one.
Yeah, already six kills, and Hagstrom and Wooten combined, 16 kills on the outside, and I'm just impressed with Long Beach State balance offensively.
Clint Coe is in as the blocking specialist, and Hagstrom rips the ace. Wow, Long Beach is serving on the good side, Heather, has been impressive.
Great high toss, gets on top of it, creates a ton of topspin and movement. That's a tough combination.
Ace number six.
And continuing to pick on Jonathan Olliman, serving the middle of the court.
And now Hillman's gone out, and Chris Gorney comes in. I was wondering when they might do this. Gorney can play middle, he can play opposite. Coming over the net.
Setter always wins the joust.
High left, and the block.
And a little stink guy to boot.
I'm still not sure if I'm a big fan of taking your setter out to have a similar size guy. Clint Coe may be the greatest 6'3 blocker in America, but I still don't like the idea of taking your setter out when Hildebrand went out. Pessoa to serve, 25-18. Tell you what, let's give some credit to number 20 on Long Beach State, Paul Munoz. He's been passing nails. That one right on the money.
Yeah, he's dishing up a little bit of nectar, making Hildebrand look like the all-world setter that he's become. Great one-handed set off the tight pass, and David Lee scooping up number 8.
Off the tape. Barbosa serve, okay. And Gorney is rejected. Chris Gorney, who predicted a 3-game sweep and that Long Beach would get the silver, gets roofed.
Great read. You see Long Beach State's block wait, read the set, and then react.
Barbosa. Left side. Long Beach is humming. Wooten again. Wooten now with 11 kills. He's hitting 500. And another substitution coming in. They seldom use Taylor Evans, a sophomore from Alamo, California. This might be the last stand for BYU in this particular game. 28-18 Beach. Short spinner, good idea. Poor execution. So far, each game has been a blowout. 1 to Long Beach, 2 to BYU. Game 3 here. Now BYU would like to try to get a little momentum if they could. Another great pass. And Tyler Hildebrand with a slam tip.
And why isn't anybody reading that? Yes, Evans just came onto the floor, but he has to be aware that Hildebrand's a front row setter and can become an attacker.
Second kill. First game point. Hildebrand flies it long. Remember that name, Tyler Hildebrand, the setter of the future.
There you see the 3-person serve receive. Hildebrand, a back row setter now, will come out of the back row. Has 3 hitters to set to.
Second game point for Long Beach. For the win, yes. Duncan Buttinger. So Long Beach, after winning game 1, losing game 2, the Beach gets back on the good side and hammers BYU 30-29. So high fives all around. Duncan Buttinger, Scott Tyszynski, and gang lead it 2-1. Don't go away. Pivotal game 3. Long Beach trying to rev up behind Scott Tyszynski. Of course, Tom Peterson's BYU Cougars coming off a big game 2, but in game 3, it was all Beach again. David Lee got hot in the middle, hitting and blocking. So did Duncan Buttinger. And when it was over, Long Beach cruising to a 30-20 win. We haven't had a close game yet, as Long Beach State leads 2-1 in this best 3 out of 5 game series. Along with Heather Cox, I'm Chris Marlowe. Heather, stats after 3, what do you expect to see?
Well, you're a poet and you know it. Hitting percentage just critical. In game 3, BYU hit a poor 0.034. Give a lot of credit to Long Beach for serving those 6 aces and their 5 blocks to really force BYU out of any offensive rhythm.
Jeff Wooten has 11 kills and has been outstanding, a candidate for the all-tournament team. Long Beach State has won one national championship. It was back in 1991. Brent Hillier was the big star, and his main man at middle blocker was Alan Knipe. Yes, Alan Knipe, the coach for Long Beach State now.
And you know, it's interesting. Yesterday, Alan told me, he was asked, what's the biggest difference between finishing first and finishing second? And after joking, well, the big difference is you get a gold ring if you're the champion, and you just get a measly watch if you come in second. He said, you have an unspoken bond with your team for the rest of your life. He said, at the beginning of the year, every team has the exact same goal. You're the only one that eventually attains it, and that just forms a lifetime bond that he will never forget.
And Long Beach State starts with a jump floaty into the net. So BYU, they switch sides, and it is apparent that BYU may be on the good side now. We shall see. All of the games have been won on the left side of the court so far. There's the left side, and the right side of the court hasn't been so kind. And that service error right back at you. Moreno pops one out of bounds. BYU's titles coming in 99 and 2001. Kaczynski. Big serving in game one. Put a lot of pressure, however, on BYU in game three.
Exactly. To me, it's not about the aces. It's about how many points they score in his serving rotation and how many multiple possessions they have on one rotation of Kaczynski's. If BYU is able to side out consistently after just one or two Kaczynski serves, BYU is doing their job. If Kaczynski serves three, four, five times in a row, then they're not.
Kaczynski, modest numbers, 8 kills. 4 errors, he has 4 digs, it's Maces. Batista goes and gets it. And Holloman, no, he's looking for the touch. Thought he had a touch, but none of the officials saw it.
Wow, I'm kind of on Holloman's side that time. Looked Maybe. Like he got high hands.
Didn't get enough of it though. Not quite enough. And set to serve it is Nathan Hextrom. Batista, yes, Victor Batista, putting up good numbers. A reminder, you can log on to ncasports.com, your official home for NCAA championship coverage, ncasports.com. Go there and find out what you want to know about NCAA coverage and sports, and now Victor Batista will serve it. Perfect pass, and the put away. So Long Beach able to set the middles a little bit more in the last game. And Lee and Budinger getting into the action.
Yeah, they've had much better ball control, both Budinger and Lee. 9 kills apiece now. Budinger, the much higher efficiency, though, hitting 750.
Moreno, Pessoa, Doug, Hillman, got it.
Well, Hillman needs to start lighting it up. Light a fire. He's been very quiet, very modest throughout
the match. I think
he's
a quiet and modest guy. I don't think he's a rah-rah, fiery guy.
I'm talking about his play.
His play has
to speak that way. I mean, his body language, he's just not taking over like I've seen him do throughout the year.
Hillman, high toss. Kaczynski. Pessoa goes and gets it.
Yikes.
And, wow, BYU netted again. It's just unbelievable. The ball's coming over. You're standing right there.
This is a team that is just playing tight, playing very atypical. Watch Carlos Moreno go right into the net with his body. I mean, he's just out of sorts right now.
Hillman gets the kill. Yeah, that's a play you don't want to make, especially in that situation. So Hillman gets the kill. Where are the Hillman numbers, Michael? 6 kills, 4 errors, hitting just 133. Tom Peterson, cool, calm, and collected on that sideline. Pessoa serving. BYU leading 5-4. That's going to be a point as Holloman kills the overpass. Nothing more demoralizing, except maybe a clean ace, is when you pass one over the net and the other guy tees off on you.
And that tells you how important serving is. That play just epitomizes it. Overpass creating an easy point, starting with the serve.
6-4. Good serve. Handled well. Burke. Into the middle. Nice up by Munoz. Kaczynski got it right on the line.
Boy, that's frustrating if you're a BYU fan. Mike Burke gets two consecutive blocks. Neither one go down. This time the soft block picked up easily by Munoz, creating great transition in the sharp cross court. The book on Tuzinski is you take away the line and you force him to hit sharp cross court, but your defense has to be in position to dig that ball.
That was a nice hit right over the top. Burke. Hildebrandt back set. Tuzinski. They block him. Burke was there. I'll tell you what, BYU was ready for that in transition. Burke didn't move. He didn't move to go out to the outside. He just waits for him.
Yeah, there's Burke right in the middle of the court, holding. Boom. Leans to his left. He's late, but he's able to close.
Burke with his fourth block. Now he'll serve. 7-5 BYU. And BYU netted again. And give credit to Hildebrandt going up. That was going over, and Hildebrandt got it before.
But Batista was way too greedy that time. He could have gotten up and blocked the ball. Instead, he tried to swing at it, forcing the net.
Now, serving is Duncan Buttinger. Around the horn comes Victor Batista. Batista, a second-team All-American. He's got 8 kills.
Watch the beautiful dish by Moreno, and very rarely in men's volleyball do you see that slide play, much more often run in the women's game. Off of one leg, a lot of people think you can get higher up.
Moreno with the floater. Tuzinski hit it out off the antenna, so the timing not there on the last two hits for Scott Tuzinski. 9-6 as BYU starting to get a little momentum here. Long Beach State leads the match 2-1. If the Beach wins this game, it's over. BYU trying to get it going here. Tuzinski again, and he wails another one out of bounds.
And right now, BYU has got to capitalize. Keep picking on Tuzinski. It starts with the tough serve. Force Long Beach State to become predictable.
Timeout called. 10-6 our score. BYU in command at the moment. What a week it has been. Chris Marlowe and Heather Cox frolicking on the beach. On assignment for ESPN. Someone had to do it.
Tough
we
game.
Volunteered. BYU trying to fight back. BYU trailing 2-1, but looking good here in game 4. What's BYU doing now, Heather?
I think they're serving a little bit tougher. They're forcing Long Beach State to be very predictable, and they're keen on Long Beach State stars. Tuzinski hitting just .083, and I think it's important that they continue to serve and block.
Long Beach having some trouble passing now, and Tuzinski gets the kill over Olliman. That was the matchup that Tom Peterson told me earlier tonight when I asked him who's going to block Tuzinski. He wanted Olliman there, as of the outside blockers, the 6'3 senior, the most solid guy of filling the hole and penetrating, getting over, blocking that seam.
And it also means that Batista is in the middle next to Olliman, and that's the matchup that they didn't have in game 1 that they were able to create in game 2 by flipping the rows.
Good serve for Tuzinski, and Hildebrandt gets the kill. So the senior from Las Vegas, who had 3 aces against Penn State when he was serving, had 19 kills in the Mountain Pacific Sports Federation win over Long Beach, so he's been good against Long Beach. Out of the back line, got it. Wooten. So Jeff Wooten, a senior, we mentioned 5 seniors. I want to tell you something, Heather, that I don't know if you knew, but do you know that everybody on Long Beach State's team has brown hair?
Well, you're
every
deep
single
for that
guy,
one.
The 6 starters, the 6 subs.
Boy, we have questions, you have answers.
A few of the coaches. That's an ace! That's an ace, Alan Knipe, and one of his assistants. That was a beauty right into the corner. Wow. All the fans for BYU have, for Long Beach have brown hair.
You've done some little investigative journalism.
You don't hear that from most commentators. Every player on Long Beach, brown hair. There's one. There's another.
So if you're a recruit and you want to go to Long Beach, go get that bottle of dye
that's
for
right.
a blondie.
And if you can jump and hit the D, that's even better. Batista out of bounds. So Long Beach gets a couple in a row, and it's 12-10. So BYU nursing a 2-point lead. Alan Knipe trying to figure out how to guide his team to the championship. One-on-one, Pessoa is roofed. Hildebrandt was there. Tyler Hildebrand, 6'4". He's got some wheels on him, Heather.
Yeah, and the Beach now racking up their sixth team block. Alan Knipe said blocking would be the difference in this one.
Right back to Pessoa. Spinning it up. Right back over. Oh my gosh, BYU netted again.
And guys, this is not the officials calling it tight. This is BYU just flat out floundering into the net. I mean, they are tight, they are wound up, they are playing uncharacteristic volleyball right now.
David Lee with the serve, we're tied 12-12. Ball dug, Wambi starting to get some momentum. BYU needs a kill bad here. Burke, yes. Well, that set was a little off mark. Burke having to use his left hand, his good pectoral to guard that, to guide that through Heather. And he gets the kill. Burke putting up nice numbers. 7 kills, only 1 error, hitting 429. He's got 5 block assists and a dig. And now Hillman will serve. BYU by 1. Fourth game. Into the head. Mew. Buttinger gets the kill.
Boy, it's amazing to watch Buttinger's performance, not only in the semis, but tonight, playing with a very heavy heart. We talked about it on Thursday, his grandmother unexpectedly passing away this week. And hopefully getting a little bit of solace and relief on the court from a very emotional time.
13 all. Pessoa. They're way too far out on Pessoa. Pessoa's a cross-court crank hitter. He's got 12 kills, and he's rolling up his sleeves now for spiking duty. Pessoa to serve. BYU by 1. And down the line, Tyszynski got in late, still able to put it away. So Tyszynski gets his 11th kill.
I think the biggest difference for BYU in this match, it is not scoring on points that Long Beach is giving them. The easy ones, the gimmies. BYU just giving it away right now, not capitalizing when they can against Long Beach.
Wooten into the net, so BYU gets it back. Of course, BYU finishing as the runner-up a year ago to Lewis in one of the great championship finals of all time. You have to wonder if maybe some of those dark thoughts would creep into BYU.
Well, and I continued to think that as well and asked a lot of the players about that yesterday. They all insisted that because of the experience factor and because they're so familiar with Long Beach, that the Lewis match wouldn't creep in. I don't know how it doesn't. I mean, if you get behind, you start to doubt, could this happen again?
Robert Kieski is in to serve, the senior from Huntington Beach. See if he can get it in. He's got the jump floater working, I believe, if I remember right. Yeah. Holloman. And Holloman gets the kill. John Holloman's had a great career. He wants to go to law school and become an announcer, Heather.
He wants your chair.
No, he wants your chair.
I think he wants your chair.
No, he doesn't.
No, we're going to have to fight.
Marlo and Holloman with you from, where is it next year, Michael?
The partnership of.
At UCLA. No, I'm just kidding. What would I do without you?
I'm replaceable. I know.
Down the line, Hagstrom. Hagstrom's been pretty good on the left. They haven't been able to stop him much. 7 kills for Nate. 16 all. Game to 30. Win by 2. Win by at least 2, or a minimum of 2. And Tyszynski with the ace. 5 aces in the match for Scott Tyszynski.
Unbelievable what an impact that Scott Tyszynski has had from the service line. When he's not racking up aces, he's putting himself and his team in an incredible position to score points.
Here he comes again. Pessoa's on top of it. And nobody up as the Long Beach blockers jumped and bumped into each other. Great set by Carlos Moreno.
And I think if you're BYU, the body language, the negative energy has to stop. You have to believe if we can just get to a fifth game, we start from scratch. BYU knows it's not playing its best. They just want to hang on.
Serve is just out. Well, BYU can stop touching the net. They've got a chance to win game 4. That ball just out of bounds. Tom Peterson's team making some uncharacteristic errors. And now set to serve is Hagstrom. 18-17 Beach. And that serve is on the line for an ace.
I'm sorry, I'm frustrated over the last two calls.
And Tom Peterson saying no, no, no.
Two in a row. The first serve was as in as an out ball can be. This ball is as out as an in ball can be. That ball is out.
Wait a second. Tom Peterson thought it was out.
Yeah, I'm with you, coach.
So an ace there for Long Beach State. One more look. Maybe we can slow this down and see. It's the ninth ace.
If it touches any part of the white line, the ball is good, but it is on the wide side. It's in the green, right?
Oh, wait a
second. No, that's the shadow. Run it a little bit farther. Right there, it bounced out.
Let's bring it back. Let's bring it back.
Right there, it's out.
That's a close one, baby. That's a tough one. If you're BYU, you certainly want to complain about that. The service story really has favored Long Beach. Nine aces, 17 errors. That's a great ratio.
Yeah, that's a great bedtime story for Long Beach State, but that will keep BYU fans up tonight. Just one ace. You want a 2 or 3 to 1 ace to error ratio.
Right now, we're in the midst of it. Game four, Chris Marlowe and Heather Cox in Long Beach State, which hasn't won a title since 1991, has the lead, 1917, here in game four. They're up 2-1, so if they win this game, it's over. And the timeout works.
And the Peterson gives the line official a little stink eye. That might be the first time in my life I've seen stink eye from Tom Peterson. He's just standing there glaring at the line judge.
Now, Victor DeBatista, oh, he's going to the float serve, short. Pretty good one. And Batista can't get there. David Lee puts it through. This Long Beach State team, it's a group of guys that have been playing together for a long time, with the exception of Hildebrand, a bunch of very, very good friends.
That are eager and hungry. Everybody came to Long Beach State 4 years ago. The senior class as freshmen came together and said, we've got one goal, and this is their last chance, and they know it.
Thiago Barbosa in to serve, and he misses it. Ooh. A couple of serving errors for the Beach. Back comes Paul Munoz. Long Beach by one. Set to serve it is Joe Hillman. Still plenty of time for BYU to do some damage here. Set left, tip. Hildebrand. Nice, up Alleman. They'll go to Pessoa. Hildebrand, high set. Wooten. Oh, that was Alleman again. Long rally. Which team? Left side, Wooten. Got it. Jeff Wooten for mayor of Long Beach. Run him.
Nice transition, starts with the defense. Look at Alleman, giving it everything he has. I like the misdirection by Moreno, but Long Beach is too much. Wooten continuing to get it done. 14 kills now to lead all players.
21-19. They played three times. In two of the three matches, BYU won in five. So you would think if they went to five, BYU would have the advantage. The third consecutive serving error for Long Beach. This was it. Five games on January 28th. BYU winning in five again, BYU winning in four on May 1st.
And it is just so hard to beat the same team four times in one season. I know that Coach Peterson continually said it doesn't matter, it gives us the confidence, but I think in his deepest, darkest moments when he's staying up and he can't sleep last night, he's thinking, how on earth do I pull this off for the fourth time? And I think it showed today. BYU has come out as the tighter team. Long Beach, you saw in the open of our show, was much more relaxed.
Kaczynski is roofed. John Alleman, the matchup that Tom Peterson wanted. Oh, man.
And it's a deceptive matchup. Alleman does not have the height advantage, but look at the great swing block.
Beautiful.
Turns his body into the court. That's just picturesque.
22-21 BYU, and you have to think Long Beach State shooting itself in the foot just a bit with the four service errors. Well, John Alleman, he's been around for a while. He's a senior. He just had the block of his career. Let's get to know him a little bit better.
Hey, I'm John Alleman, senior outside hitter from Yorba Linda, California.
I'm a Mormon and I served a church mission in Bulgaria from the year 98 to 2000. I'm one of four players married on BYU's team, and I'll celebrate my first anniversary on May 16th next Sunday. Happy anniversary, Tiffany. This weekend's gonna be the last volleyball weekend of my life. I'm looking forward to hopefully closing it out with a national championship. Then I'll finish up my master's degree in accounting and hopefully become a CPA.
Alleman started off slow, had three errors, no kills in game one, but boom, what a difference it's made. Nine kills now, Alleman with that great stuff block. Jonathan, one of four players married. There's the group of wives. Fernando Pessoa's wife, Megan Shoup Pessoa, a gymnast at BYU. All of the wives, very good friends. And according to Fernando, very animated. They get pretty rowdy during the matches. They don't like to sit with their family. They like to sit together and heckle and cheer and yell and scream.
BYU has come back from a two-point deficit, Long Beach State, with some service errors. And now Fernando Pessoa, one of the veterans of that 2001 NCAA championship team, who's been there along with Alleman. Into the middle, ball dug, Pessoa. Set right, that's a trap set. And Alleman was doing the mambo under the net, nobody there. And the spike out of bounds, Long Beach. Thought Alleman was under, but his foot was still in contact with the line. So a great play by John Alleman. He was on the line, but the foot still in contact. And Moreno says, that was the worst set I've given you. Sorry.
Tightrope walking.
Sorry, buddy.
My bad.
23-21. Long Beach State having troubles here. And Jasinski gets the kill. 23-22. Game is to 30. Must win by at least two. And now Jasinski sets for frontline duty. Jeff Wooten, who's played very well, is going to serve it. Crowd is quiet here. Not sure who to root for. And Wooten into the net. So that's the fourth in a row, the fifth service error in this game for Long Beach State. BYU, 5 out of the last 6 points.
Yeah, Long Beach State just giving away points right now.
Here comes the Palisades Dolphin of yesteryear, Rob Nielsen. Set to serve it up. 24-22, BYU. Jasinski, Alleman was there. And the put away. That's a big one for Hagstrom. Moreno thought he had it.
Boy, and Moreno is mad, yelling at his team. Alleman got the block, but he didn't continue to play defense. That ball dropped right to where Alleman should have been playing defense as a left front player. Moreno begging his team for a little support.
Duncan Budinger will serve it. Moreno, Hillman, blocked up. Set left, Hagstrom hit it out. Hagstrom hit it out, and BYU gets another point. Are we going to five games?
I think we are, Chris. For the first time in this match, I'm hearing Joe Hillman yelling for the ball from Moreno, getting involved, getting vocal.
BYU by a couple. David Lee snaps one through. Perhaps Long Beach needs more middle production. Although it's tough to set the quick, because if you get blocked, it's going straight down.
Well, their strength throughout this match has been balance, really setting from antenna to antenna.
Here may be the game for BYU. Scott Jasinski at the service line. Can he get it in? Pretty good pass. Back set, Alleman. Oh, what a dig in the back line by Munoz.
Spike
is blocked, and no, it did not cross. Four contacts.
And Chris, I think that could be the turning point in this game, because BYU was able to side out of Jasinski's serving rotation without any points being scored against them.
Now Alleman works his way up. Is Shorty coming? No, right down the line. Back set, Jasinski. He's blocked. Boy, that ball went down so fast. Couldn't see it. Pessoa was there.
And you know, Chris, this BYU team all day yesterday continuously told me we manage to score points when our backs are against the wall. When we need it, we can get it.
Into the middle to Lee and right through the hands of Olmstead. So make it a two-point advantage. There is Sean Olmstead, the libero for BYU. Now, set to serve is Hagstrom. Cougs by two. Boy, BYU passing has been outstanding.
Oh, no, again.
BYU netted again. I think it was Moreno. The pass was tight.
But you know what? As a setter, you'd start drooling over those types of passes right at the net. And there's Moreno, head and shoulders into the net. I've never seen so many net violations by one team in a match, Chris.
Dom Peterson, his 19th year of coaching, his second year at BYU. They finished as the runner-ups. He was voted the 1994 NCAA Coach of the Year, leading Penn State to the first ever title. He is a good one. BYU has won almost all the tight games from Long Beach State this year. They won the first two matches in five, and they've been able to pull out some squeakers. What's been the key for them?
Scoring points in crunch time. This is a mature team. This is a veteran team. I've seen it as little in this match as I have all season, though, the ability to pull it out. We've watched it right here in the end of game four. Talk about points in crunch time. It is right now for the Cougars.
27-26 BYU. Fourth game. Long Beach set to serve. It'll be Nathan Hagstrom. Hagstrom with three aces on the night. Moreno back set. Hillman got it. Joe Hillman.
Great timeout by Coach Peterson, getting his team together mentally and coming up with a great play out of the timeout.
Back into the front line, Michael Burke. BYU 2 points away from game four victory.
Good blocking rotation for the Cougars. Good passing for Long Beach State.
Into the middle, Lee sneaking it through there. David Lee, and boy, Hildebrand taking a chance and sneaking a quick set. So here's the big play of game four. 28-27, the Beach could tie it if BYU gets it. They're going to bring in Clint Coe to block. So Coe is in, Hildebrand out. Moreno, Burke is blocked! Burke is blocked, and BYU can't play it up.
Long Beach State has been a superb blocking team.
28 all. Long serve, it's out! David Lee served it out, and BYU exhales. Long Beach State leads the match 2-1. BYU trying to close out game two. BYU will have its first game point at 29-28. Hillman serving. Hildebrand sets quick, 29-all. Once again, you must win by at least two. You gotta have a 2-point differential. Long Beach State serving 22 service errors with 9 aces. 8 service errors this game. Moreno tipping, yes!
Both setters taking over.
Carlos Moreno, how did he have the guts to do it?
Because quite honestly, and I think he'd admit this, he hasn't had the match he's wanted to have so far.
Second game point for BYU. Hildebrand into the middle and sucking.
And now it becomes a side-out war. The difference will be who can score the real points with the block and with the serve.
Wooten to serve at 30-all. No cap. But so a perfect pass. And jamming it over is Carlos Moreno. So Moreno with 2 dumps in a row. Surprising but effective.
And amazing considering the last time he wanted to dump before those 2 kills, he netted. This is a player very competitive.
Third game point for the Y. Back set to Zinski is roofed. John Ollerman was there. So BYU wins game four. 32-30 the final. And we're going to the 5th and final game. Yes, folks, stay with us. The 5th and final game for the national championship coming up next. Game four had a little bit of everything. BYU and Long Beach. Long Beach up 2-1. A controversial call seemed to ignite BYU. Hillman got it going, but it was the blocking of John Olliman and Fernando Pessoa that really took effect. They were able to stuff Scott Tuzinski, Olliman, Pessoa. Yes, and BYU pulls out game four, 32-30. Oh, a squeaker. Chris Marlowe and Heather Cox were back. Fifth and final game to 15 is coming up.
Key will be the matchups that they get in the first rotation. BYU finding success when they get the matchups they want, and also finding success in five-game matches. 5-2 record, of course, two of those wins coming against this very same Long Beach State squad.
If you're going with experience and you're going with history, you've got to favor BYU. Long Beach, however, has been kind of the fighting underdog team all year. They put it together. They haven't been able to beat BYU in a five-game match. They've had two opportunities, couldn't do it. This will be their third. BYU knows how to close these out. Can they do it one more time?
Alan Knipe asked his team to play at a higher level for longer. That's exactly what he must have been talking about during the break between games four and five.
And can Scott Tuzinski not only get his serve in, but be a big factor hitting-wise? So here we go. Tuzinski will start it off, the best server for Long Beach State. Maybe the best server in America. Can he get it in at the start? Carl McGowan, my old coach, used to say, seven times you have to get your serve in. One is at the start of a game. And he does. We're underway. Game five. Hillman got it. So Joe Hillman starting to pump up his numbers a bit.
He's steadily improved throughout this match. Slow start, now into double digits with 10 kills.
Olliman. Into the middle, Lee is blocked. Hillman, quick set.
Wow. Second set, throwing at the one, I like it.
There you go, and Long Beach into the net to boot. So BYU, quick start. Remember, it's point per play, but we're only going to 15, so stay with us.
Now let's see how BYU's defense does. In game four, the difference was its blocking. Had four blocks alone in game four, and Olliman was huge. Had three kills in that fourth and decisive game.
Olliman with the service error. Tied two games apiece. Glad you're with us for live volleyball, live in Honolulu. I know it's dark out where you're watching, folks, but the sun has not set yet in Honolulu or on either of these teams. Fernando Pessoa hit it out. He's raising his hands, but he missed one. So Pessoa, the Brazilian. Moreno, the Brazilian. Batista, the Dominican. Half of this BYU squad. 2-2. Pessoa is rejected. Tyler Hildebrand was there. The setter got him.
And very rarely do you see a BYU team not score off of a perfect pass, but this set is way off the net. Gets behind Pessoa's shoulder, and Long Beach State's block continuing to score points.
3-2. Straight up. And back row. So Moreno having some problems at the net. Been called for numerous nets on tight passes, and Tom Peterson taking a very quick timeout. So BYU calls its first timeout. Fifth and final game, Long Beach on top by a couple early. If you like the glass off, do a little late afternoon surfing here in Hawaii. The conditions are just about right. We're in Honolulu, Hawaii. Chris Marlowe and Heather Cox. Fifth and final game here at the Stan Sheriff Center, Long Beach State. And BYU tied up two games apiece. Alan Knipe right behind the official there. A player in 91 who won the championship. Trying to get his first as a coach. Hillman, and Hillman has been doing a lot of that. I think if you're gonna block Hillman, why not go cross court?
Great one-on-one opportunity. Starts with the good pass. Moreno getting a good set, making it very hard for Long Beach to commit on any one player.
So now, Victor Batista, he was jump serving early, but now he's been utilizing a flaw that's way out, and the crowd gets on him.
If you are not gonna jump serve, if you're gonna stand on the ground and float serve, you have to serve it in. That's the reason he chose to do it. Crucial mistake.
The second float service error this game for BYU. Off the top, Going to get it? No, the put away for Hillman. So Hillman right now looks like the most relaxed of the BYU players.
And so if you're Moreno, you just keep feeding your heart, your hot arm until Long Beach proves they can stop him.
Big Joe Hillman is exhausted. He's been cheering for 4.25 games so far. And his son has really come alive here. 5-4 Long Beach. Blocking it at the net was Burke.
And that's something we haven't seen in this match so far. Before, BYU was very anxious and was netting on those plays. That time they were patient. They waited for the ball to cross the plane of the net. Smart play.
Michael Burke, the 6'8 junior with the jam. And we'll be back. A year ago, BYU in the same situation against the Lewis Flyers. This was championship point. BYU trying to get one more put away.
Hits it out! And Lewis!
The ball hit out.
And
Lewis winning the championship. A 5-gamer. Now BYU has a chance to make amends. And don't think that these Cougars haven't thought about that loss. That is what has propelled the Cougars all season long.
I'm telling you, they've thought about it every single day for the last 365 of them. I mean, there's no way that doesn't live in your head.
5-5. Popped up into the scoreboard. And once again, the rule, if the ball goes up and hits any impediment up top, as long as it stays on your side, it's playable.
And I apologize to the fans listening, but that ball was so close to me. And as a former player, you just got to yell at your team. Go
Heather,
play that ball.
Let's see you do the sprawl out there, Heather.
I'm
go
ready.
Get it.
Give me some knee pads.
6-5. Careful, Heather. 6-5 Long Beach has the lead here in the fifth and final game. Chris Marlowe, Heather Cox, Long Beach in the dark uniforms, BYU in white. Moreno inside. Oh my gosh! Moreno set it inside. I'm not sure if Pessoa was ready for that. And I have to tell you honestly, Moreno looks nervous. The setter looks nervous here.
I have never seen two brain cramps in a fifth game of a national championship like those two.
7-5, the quick set spiked out by Burke. Long Beach gets another point. Now the teams, midway through the game, are going to switch sides. 25 hitting errors for BYU. All of the games in this match have been won on the good side or the left side of the court. And pressure now on the NCAA Player of the Year, Carlos Moreno, to lead his team.
Yeah, he admitted a year ago he was tight. He wasn't prepared for the pressure of this type of match. He said, every day I have trained to prepare myself to play better in the championship.
Hildebrand serving. Oh, and he serves it into the net. Hildebrand, a mistake, a big one there. The 23rd serving error for the Beach. So it is 8-6 Long Beach. Hildebrand, quick set, off a head. That's okay, off Olliman's head. Free ball. Hildebrand sets left, and Tuzinski. Tuzinski's been blocked by Holloman, so he's being very careful out there now.
If both coaches have the matchup they want, Holloman blocking Tuzinski.
9-6, Long Beach leads in a game to 15. Now, Wooten is coming out, and in to serve will be Robert Kieski.
Talk about pressure. You're cold, you've been on the bench, you serve out, your opponent gets a point.
Fifth and final game of the national championship. Long Beach ahead by 3. Kieski. Holloman shanks it straight up. Holloman on the left. Oh, and he's roofed! The best block of Duncan Buttiger's career. Buttiger was there.
Blocking has been the difference for this Long Beach State team. Beautiful penetration, both of them hip to hip. Absolutely nowhere for BYU to go.
Timeout call, 10-6, Long Beach State leading BYU, a 4-point advantage. Alan Knight on Long Beach State's only national championship team back in 1991. A little earlier, we asked him what it would mean to be a player and a coach on a winning championship team. Here he is.
If you're willing to sacrifice the time, the efforts, the everything that goes into it, it's amazing. The only comparison I would say is that I appreciate the national championship I won as a player probably more now than I did as a junior in college, young and naive and thinking this is the greatest thing, but I was in the finals last year. I'm a junior. We just won it, and you just think that it just happens. So I think now I understand that there's a lot more that goes into it than just showing up in the arena and winning the right match.
Brent Hilliard was the man on that team. He was the star. Knight was the buddy. Brent Hilliard, the only volleyball jersey men's ever retired at Long Beach State, number 7. And now Allen Knight, just 5 points away from his first national championship. Tyler Hildebrand is pumped up. But BYU, can they make a rally here? Can the Cougars rebound for some shaky play in the middle of this game?
Right now, it's all about composure and execution. Who has the mental toughness to endure these last few points?
Got to get the serve in, and if you had a target, you would target Alleman, I think. Here's Kieski at 10-6. Back to Alleman, and he served it out. Oh, man. Is that foreshadowing of gloom to come, gloom and doom?
Well,
or is
it
just a missed serve on the way to the title?
The service story continues to tell what's going on. 24 errors now. But they have gotten 9 points off a tough serving.
10-7, set to serve is Rob Nielsen. Both teams nervous, shank pass. Tuzinski with the drive. Scott Tuzinski, that's how we get down, baby.
Huge approach, takes a huge three-step approach, great footwork, and up against a three-person block. How do you do it?
The biggest spike of his career. Long Beach leading now 11-7. Set left, Alleman, yes. John Alleman pounding down the line. 10 kills for J.A., 11-8 now. Some say you can't rally in rally scoring. Well, we know that's not true. Points can come very quickly. Now, substitution.
Wow,
checking
this is gutsy.
In. Chris Corney, the 6'6 senior blocking specialist, is coming in to block Scott Tuzinski.
Wow.
Gorney predicted a three-game sweep. Hadn't worked out that way. Into the middle, off speed. Olmstead's got it. Gorney off the bench. Long Beach on the run. Hildebrand pops it up. And BYU blocks back. Batista was there.
And Tom Peterson showing why he's the coach. Here I am really wondering why Gorney's coming in for Hillman. At this point of the match, sure enough, he puts up a triple block and scores the point.
Long Beach State, Allen Knight, one timeout remaining. BYU out of it. Moreno serving. David Lee couldn't get good wood on it. They'll set Gorney. Gorney off speed. Hildebrand, who's he got? Tuzinski. Not yet. Good dig by BYU. Gorney. No! David Lee is there. The Lee Monster. 12-9. Now, Tom Peterson will bring back in Joe Hillman.
And now Long Beach State in its best scoring rotation. 5 aces tonight, but also setting up his team to score on the block.
12-9 Beach. Tuzinski. Pretty good pass. Moreno back set. Alleman got it. John Alleman. Now Alleman will rotate to the back line. The game is to 15 for the championship. Fifth and final game. Long Beach State leading by 2. Would you set the quick here if you're Hildebrand?
On a perfect pass, you betcha.
Maybe. But don't forget, Batista is there. Alleman. Out of the back line. Ball popped up. 4 contacts. So Long Beach State. And here comes the timeout by Allen Knight. What a match between the two top teams in the nation.
And quite honestly, this is what everybody anticipated. All season long, it's been all about BYU and Long Beach State. The question was, who was going to be number one? Who was going to be number two? And these teams have battled so strong all season long.
If you've stuck with us, you have seen one of the great Final Fours, the great championship matches in history. Last year we thought was a beauty, BYU and Lewis. This one just as good.
Absolutely hasn't disappointed. We have seen two of the best offenses in the country neutralize one another because of great serving and blocking. And right now, such a huge difference between first and second place. I got second, and I know it means absolutely nothing to come away a loser in this match.
BYU down by 1. Scott Tuzinski will get a set or two here coming down the stretch. Tuzinski is wearing number 9. He is the man for Long Beach State. And Tyler Hildebrand knows it. He's saying, yep, I am the man. Set me the ball. Now on the other side of the court, Carlos Moreno and company, they've done a pretty good job of blocking Tuzinski. Would they be keying on him here?
I think so. I think you read block and you read the pass as well to know what their tendencies are. But blocking, I think, is going to be the difference in the next few points of this match. Who can score those real points and not just score on serve receive?
If I'm BYU, I'm thinking Tuzinski right now. I'm loading up on the left side for Tuzinski. 12-11. Oh, my gosh! The service error into the net. How costly can you get out of a timeout?
Yeah, great timeout by Coach Knight, trying to ice the server. A lot like a coach in basketball, icing the free throw guy.
Clint Coe in the block. Hagstrom with three aces to serve. 13-11, Long Beach. Shank pass, Hillman, big spike here. He's got it! Little Joe Hillman, and he might be cramping. Reach down to pull up his foot, make it 13-12. Now, pressure on BYU to get the serve in.
And don't forget, last time Victor Batista served, he stayed on the ground, float served, and floated it out of bounds.
Burke in the front line. Left side, off the top, BYU, chance for transition here. BYU can tie it. Hillman, got it! Little Joe Hillman with the blast. And we're tied at 13. Both teams out of timeouts. Got to set Tuzinski here, don't you? Got to set the twos at 13 all.
You've got Lee in the front row on a good pass. Tuzinski, a back row player.
Good pass. Set again left. And Wooten puts it away. I can't believe it. Wooten got it. And now, Long Beach State, its first championship point. Will BYU go to Hillman? Can David Lee get the serve in? The first championship try since 1991 for the Beach. Over the net! Oh, the set for the win! And it's going to be BYU ball. Oh, Tyler Hildebrand had a swing for the championship, and he didn't do it. 14-0. Hildebrand should have taken a cut. He had a chance. Long Beach nervous. BYU nervous. The announcers are nervous. Now Hillman will serve it. Must win by at least two. Easy serve. Into the middle, and the put away for Duncan Buttinger. And young Chase Buttinger down in San Diego says, that's my brother.
My boy, nobody could be happier than Hildebrand, though, who now gets to serve for the match.
Second championship points for Long Beach. The Beach can wrap it up right here. Set left, Pessoa puts it away. Fernando Pessoa. Each time this year, when Long Beach and BYU have played, BYU has been able to win the close games, the close matches. Will it happen again here? 15-0, Pessoa to serve. Left side, and spiking off was Tuzinski. Hildebrand will go back and hand the ball to Wooten. Long Beach State, its third championship point. Serving Jeff Wooten. Passes off the net. Set left side. Ball dug up. Oh, Long Beach. Two players had a chance to go. Long Beach very, very nervous.
And neither team disappointing right now. What an incredible game five we are seeing from 10 on. I mean, just trading side outs and side outs back and forth.
Hildebrand should have gone after that baby. Burke, shank pass. Left side, Hagstrom, that did not clear. And BYU now, can you believe it? BYU is going to have its first championship point to make amends for last year. Tom Peterson.
Slowing things down, wiping up the floor. Both teams out of timeouts, trying to change the momentum any way that they can.
17-16 Cougars. Michael Burke to serve for the win. Back set, Tuzinski, got it! Scott Tuzinski with his 17th kill. Fifth and final game, must win by a minimum of 2 points.
And there is no cap, folks. A year ago in game one, we went 46-44.
Buttinger with the serve. Coming over the net. Batista has it, he falls down. Olliman kills it anyway. John Olliman, clutch.
100% pressure has been on Holloman's shoulders this entire match. Mr. Money right now.
So now Carlos Moreno has a chance to end things for the Cougars. Tuzinski, he hit it out, and BYU has won the national championship. For the Cougars, down 10-6 and 12-9. They come all the way back to pull it out. 19-17, overcoming 3 match points.
BYU said all season long they had the maturity and the composure. Somehow they willed their way to score points when they had to, when their backs were against the wall. That has been Tom Peterson's trademark this entire season.